Welcome back. Well, we have Sunil Subramaniam, CEO of Sundaram Mutual Fund, joining in to discuss the fundamentals of the market. Sunil, hi. Thank you very much for joining in. It seems as though trade tariffs is really the flavor of today and hopefully not for the next couple of weeks. But in your sense, how detrimental do you think it could, say, be for the Indian equity market?
No, I don't think specifically this tariff, apart from a sentimental sell-off perspective. So, if you look at it, we are more concerned about crude and about the dollar strengthening because the Indian macros are going to be impacted by that. But from a flows perspective, this if you look at the tariff, look at it from a slightly longer view perspective, right? If Mr. Trump is going to put sanctions on Chinese imports, right? Ultimately, the bottom line is that the American economy doesn't have cheap, either change source of commodities or cheap labor, which is what China was using to pump up the trade gap. So over a slightly longer period, America has to find a substitute because American consumer is not going to pay American labor wages to buy the same products that he is getting 50% cheaper. So this is more like setting things right with China, but ultimately they have to go out and get it from some other country because ultimately for their economy, they're just short of resources, both in people and other. So there I think lies an opportunity for a country like India because simple statistics, you know, in terms of per capita income, and I want to draw that to the wages. China is today around $8,000 per capita income. 10 years ago, right, 2005-ish, it was at $2,000. India is today $2,000. So what China has done is, over the period by being the manufacturing capital, they have sold it. But effectively, when the per capita income goes up, it means that the wages are also four times higher than they were a decade ago. Right, so Chinese goods are also not as cheap as they were earlier. So America, and maybe there is some smart strategic move in America that while it's still cheaper for the US to buy from China, but the fact is that it's cheaper from other countries too because their wages are still much lower, right? Because India is like one-fourth the per capita income of China. Sure. So technically any low-end wage product we could substitute. Now it's not as simple as I'm laying it out, but I'm just saying over a period of time, yes, the markets are going to react to this thing because it affects macros, it affects everything. But for the Indian economy, actually, I would say this is a good news because against a $320 billion trade deficit with China, India is $30 billion, you know, from a trade deficit. So we are one-tenth. So we are not that big in their eyes. So I think there is an opportunity for the Indian economy arising out of these tariffs. Second aspect of the market aspect is that if you see Indian market, I think you were mentioning in the earlier show that Indian markets are more resilient. And the resilience arises because there's a sharp polarization today between the world and in India. In India, both the domestic micro, which is the earnings, as well as the domestic flows are strong. And these are what are supporting. So if you see, FIs have been net sellers, domestic DIs have been net buyers, mutual funds being key among them. So I think from a market perspective, the resilience will continue because SIP flows continue to go unabated. They're about 7,000 crores a month. And the domestic investor, retail investor is still showing resilience in terms of putting his money in. So I think from an Indian stock market perspective, that this volatility is being used by mutual funds to buy those quality companies that they are. Yes, there are the Hava companies, those which went up on momentum. Those are correcting steeply and nobody is buying them. But good quality companies which we already hold in our portfolio where you're now seeing a correction is a very good time to average because that's the time. And you see the industry is also, if you see there's a slew of close-ended funds being launched by the mutual fund industry. Because what the industry is also realizing is that if you divert these flows into close-ended, then the daily NAV pressure of an open-ended scheme versus locking that money up for, let's say, a three-year period, I think it's working. So then from an Indian market perspective, I think that while it will be volatile, the resilience of the market vis-a-vis other emerging markets will continue to be.
The big story for the last 10 days has been pharma. And you were just telling us that you've also been buyers and selectively in pharmaceutical stocks. Can you talk about that?
Yeah. So there are three things around the pharma space. So first is that the regulatory overhang, which was there earlier in terms of the FDA kind of thing, I think that's kind of easing off. We see that companies are able to overcome that and do that, one. Second is the strengthening of the dollar inherently is a support for the exports of the pharma sector. Third is the world economy's revival itself means that healthcare spending, everything will go up. So I think these three factors, which pretty much work for IT too, but pharma was, because of the regulatory concern, did not pick up. So what we saw as the IT wave of the last 3 months is now translating into the pharma. That being said, we still not overweight the sector, But I think there are specific good quality companies which got hurt in the previous thing, which we are now going and picking up. Especially, we also have some closed-ended funds. We too tend to pick them up in those kind of spaces.
Okay.
You launched the value fund, I mean, a couple of months back, right?
So
you picked some pharmaceutical stocks.
Yeah, we picked some pharma stocks.
Where else is there? What else have you picked up? Value, essentially.
No, value is telecom. Value?
Telecom.
Telecom and some industrial, some of the infra pack, where we think that who will play out when the private sector capex kicks off, which is still not showing. See, the government sector capex, those supplies, already there's been a run-up. Mm. But the private sector capex, that I think we still, see, consumption is growing strongly. So we expect capacity utilization to inch up to 80% plus by the end of the year. Mm. So we think next year, same time, the capex cycle will boom. Mm. So when we launch these five-year funds, right, we are buying those stocks in which will, when their order books will show up in a year from now, that's when their valuations creep up. So we are buying those kind of cap good suppliers, EPC contractors, those who tend to benefit from the private sector into our...
And in telecom, you're buying the number one player.
Yeah, I can't talk stock names, but I guess, you know...
The idea also has corrected quite a bit, but I don't hear very many people saying that, well, there's value there, except we're talking about value.
Well, I think we're out of time, but Mr. Subramaniam, thanks very much for joining in and taking us through your fundamental view.